James Biden, who got a little bit of play in the last debate because he's the Biden that cut a gigantic deal in Iraq. Tell us about this one.
Yeah, another prime example. So James Biden gets involved with a construction company, a newly formed construction company. It begins in 2011 when Kevin Justice, who's a longtime Biden friend from Delaware, visits the White House, has meetings with Joe Biden's office. We don't know precisely who in the office, but he met with people in the office. 3 weeks after that meeting, lo and behold, Kevin Justice appoints Frank Biden, Joe's brother, as executive vice president of a newly formed construction company.
Problem being, I assume James Biden, Peter, is an expert construction guy. He's known far and wide for his acumen in this field.
Yeah, you know, he probably at some point in his life has worn a hard hat. But that's about the extent of his background. He has no background in construction. So he is now executive vice president of this new construction company. And then within 6 months, they land these billion-dollar contracts to build homes in Iraq. This is part of the Iraqi reconstruction after the war. They're contractors to it. And who is in charge of Iraqi reconstruction at the time? Joe Biden, his brother. So now got a third member of the family who, because of Joe's position, is cashing in. In this case, taxpayer money is flowing to a member of the Biden family.
So we're talking about a deal over $1 billion with outright grants from the American taxpayer to a Biden family member who had no background in construction to build homes.
To build homes in Iraq. That's correct.